Okay, so this unit behind us here, when you jump out R to Y1, the compressor doesn't start. What it doesn't know yet is it's going to get its ass beat into submission once we're through with it. Okay, I know what's wrong with it. I'm going to take you through the steps, and I'm going to show you a way that you can bypass a part when you have this particular problem to get the compressor back up and running. Let's tackle this. Okay, so there we are. R and Y1 are jumped out. This jumper's green. I know that's a bit of a weird color for a jumper, but we have those two shorted out, and the compressor is not starting. I'm going to take you over to the economizer section and show you what is going on here. Here we are in the economizer section. This is the Honeywell Jade economizer controller. Now we have an alarm here that the outdoor air sensor is an alarm. It's got an error. Now this is an enthalpy sensor, okay? It measures humidity and temperature and decides what the enthalpy, the heat content in the air. All right, so we have an error on that. I'm gonna go in and show you what it's reading right now. So we're gonna pop into status, all right? And it says economizer available, no. Economizing, no. Occupied, yes. Okay, Y1 in is on. That means it's getting a signal here. Y1 out is off. That means it's not sending a signal back to the compressor. Now if we go look at what the outdoor enthalpy sensor is reading, there it is right there. Nothing. It doesn't know what the temperature is, so it can't decide how to act. All right, so I'm gonna show you what happens here when we take the two wires and jump them out, but first I'm gonna show you that we have a signal on my meter and then no signal back out. So I have my meter on Y1 in and common there, and we have 27 volts to that terminal. The sun's shining a bit, so it's hard to see on that meter there, but we have 27 volts to Y1 in. Now we're on Y1 out, okay? We have 0 volts. Again, the sun is in the way, but we have 0 volts there. So I'm gonna take these two wires off and moret them together, or wire nut them as some of you guys say, and I'll show you what happens. So I've taken the two wires off, okay? In Canada, sometimes we call these morets. In the US, I know it's wire nuts. Twist on wire connector, I believe is the proper name for that. But we've got them connected up, and now our cooling is running. Should probably get this panel back on, but the compressor is running now. So that is a little bit of a trick. If you have a bad outdoor air sensor, you can do this to fix the problem temporarily until you run out and get one. But fortunately, we have an air sensor. We're gonna change it right now, and we're gonna get this thing all fixed up. So here's the existing one hiding in this hood here, and you can see that that terminal is a little corroded out, but we have a new one, and we have a new sensor, and we're gonna pop this in and get rid of that alarm and get this thing running normally. The sensor has been changed, and now we see that it says cool, Y1 out is on, and there we go, cooling's running. There's a sensor in there. I know it's attached to the damper, but that's where it was from factory, and I've already checked it. It opens and closes, not a problem.